Hi, I'm Mia and I play Lily.
It's amazing to have you here tonight. Can you talk about why this story, this film is so special and important?
Yeah, I think it's insanely important because it opens up conversations, which for me is personally why I love doing the job that I do. So having those conversations and particularly sharing on screen a group of young boys who open up to each other and have a beautiful friendship where they can be emotional and tell each other that they love each other.
With all of the attention that is being given to mental health awareness at the moment, do you think that particularly young men are often being unfortunately left out of that discussion?
I think definitely, yeah. I think there's still a lot of conversation to be had on, you know, toxic masculinity, as it were, where young guys don't feel like they're able to speak about their emotions and their feelings in the same way that girls do. So films like this are super important because they do start those conversations.
I mean, do you think in some respects the abundance of the use of that phrase, toxic masculinity, can sometimes be part of the problem? Because obviously, you know, young men in particular feel demonized. They don't feel like they have an identity and the ability to express their concerns and their difficulties.
Yeah, exactly that. And again, that's why films like this should and do exist. To especially putting on screen boys telling each other they love each other. And that's a really beautiful thing. And being able to open up to each other is so important.
Just in terms of your own place in that story, can you tell us a bit more about your character and what it was that appealed to you about her, not just the story overall?
Yeah, I think what's really interesting is Lily offers Sid a lot of support that he didn't necessarily know that he needed. And we get to see this relationship between a boy and a girl that isn't necessarily lead to anything romantic. It's platonic and, yeah, it's just really beautiful because they give each other what they need at that time.
Talking about relationships, can you talk about the dynamic with your director, knowing that this is such a uniquely personal story for him?
Yeah, I think that meant, you know, we all went into this with so much trust in Connor. Like, he knew what he wanted to do. And we just wanted to, like, do that justice, to be honest. And grief is something that everyone, to some degree, has experienced in their lives. So getting to have those conversations, even on set or after these screenings and stuff like that, is really important.
I'm Geoff Bell. First of all, there's no money, so you're doing it for a love of a script. And I wear the flower because I've, you know, my nan and granddad and my brother-in-law, I've lost so many people from cancer. So, you know, life's so precious and it comes from the heart. I wanted to do this film for the director, for the writer, for Connor. That's it. I'll leave you with this. I recently became an age where I had to test my poo for bowel cancer. And I know one thing. Life is precious, son. Very fucking precious.
I'm Wilson Mbomio, and I'm an actor in the film Kindling. Personally, this film is very important because I think at the time I needed it, I got to kind of retreat for 5 weeks and make a film, which is whatever actor wants to do. And I got to join a very close friend of mine in Kane's Ajaz. And I think together we were able to kind of tell a story that I think a lot of people can relate to. I think grief at times on screen has been explored in ways that's quite somber, quite bleak, and I think that this is an opportunity to kind of sprinkle some kind of orange, yellow and golden on that and have some laughter about it and kind of see where we can be happy in sending people off, you know.
Can you talk about your experience working with the rest of this amazing cast?
Yeah. Well, I mean, for me, we're all of a sort of similar age group, apart from a couple of us. I think, you know, I personally was able to get a good laugh. We've got a couple of lads from Birmingham, so there's some different energy there, but it's all very, it feels like, you know, it all feels like home. We spent a month in Colchester filming this, so we got to know each other very well. And yeah, no, it was a great laugh, and it got to work with some great professionals and some fantastic actors. Yeah.
Can you talk a little bit about working with your director and the knowledge that this is such a deeply personal story to him, uniquely so?
Well, I mean, I knew that right from the get-go. Obviously, reading it for the first time, I got that. But meeting with him, I met with him a couple of times before boarding the project, and even during the rehearsal stage, you could feel it the whole way, and you could hear it in his voice and see it in his eyes when he's talking about, you know, his friends and this. I think this story was an opportunity for us to tell his story, an adaptation of it, but also get to make it our own. And I think that, you know, you know when you're working with a director who the story is very close to and personal for, it makes an ultimately memorable experience. So, yeah, fantastic.
Hi, my name is George Somner, and I play Sid in Kindling. So, I mean, Kindling is essentially a story that starts. There's a character called Sid who's diagnosed with testicular cancer. It's not something that's alluded to very often in the film. There's the theatrics of that isn't necessarily there. It's very much a story in the same vein as Stand By Me, where there's a journey that these people go on, but throughout the film there's very much understanding what that present moment is, not only for Sid, not only for his friends or his family, but as a collective, and how they work together to not only create memories, but to be able to move forward. I think they're all supplying each other with the tools to be able to move forward, and I think that's such an interesting and important part of grief.
The dialogue about mental health and the support around those issues has never been more prevalent in our society, but obviously young men so often seem to be left out and excluded from those conversations, from those spaces. Can you talk a little bit about what this film has to teach us about young men and the importance of supporting one another?
Yeah, no, absolutely. I think that was one of the biggest things that drew me to the project, and Connor's understanding of what that world is and talking about male mental health. Because that is a big part of this film. I think for me, the characters in this are so unapologetically open with each other. They've created a space, particularly Sid and Diggs and Wolfie. Like, I think they offer a space with each other. I think some of the other boys have a bit of learning to do, as they all do, I think, throughout. But yeah, they become very open, and I think that is so, so important for young men. I think we feel, I know I felt, from a young teen up until now, do you know what I mean? So frequently, when you put yourself out there emotionally and invest energy and time into someone, it can be such a vulnerable place to be in, and I think this is kind of very much solidifying that that's fine, we're able to do that, and someone is going to be there to support you. It's about opening that conversation, starting that conversation. And then, you know, it's that a problem shared is a problem halved. I think it is very much that.
Just bringing it back to tonight and this beautiful piece of cinema, my final question, have you got a message for people about why they really should watch this film, soak up this experience and enjoy the celebration of life that this film is?
Yeah, I mean, we all have something to learn from this. I think it is very much a happy film about loss. I think it equips us, or starts to equip us, with an understanding of how to deal with grief, something we all, if we haven't dealt with it already, we will deal with it at some point in our life. And grief and difficult times is definitely something that brings us all together. We see that in this film. So yeah, as an audience member, I think we can look at it, and I think there's a really important part of it that when we get to the end of the film, when the credits roll, I feel like when I've been doing screenings of this, there is such a sense of people removing themselves from the film, the action of the film, and thinking about those that they've lost. I think that was huge for Connor to have that as part of this process as well. Like, he wanted people to be reflecting, and that, yeah, there's so much happiness to be found in those moments to reflect on who our loved ones were and how they inform us as people moving forward.